Motorola has stepped up its smartphone game. I'm Bridget Carey, and this is your CNET update. After much hype and rumor, the Moto X smartphone has been unveiled, and this is an Android phone that will be a true challenger to Samsung's Galaxy S line. This is the first flagship phone from Motorola Mobility since Google bought the company in 2011. The Moto X is born from the union of Motorola's hardware strengths with Google's software smarts. The Moto X comes closest to offering a clean Android user interface, that is, aside from the Nexus phone. There are some software tricks that make the Moto X Android experience a little different, and these are the same tricks that can be done on the brand new Motorola Droids at Verizon. There's the ability to twist your wrist to wake up the camera quickly. You can check the time and messages on the unlock screen, and without turning on the phone, it'll respond to voice commands with three magic words, "Okay, Google now." So how can it be always listening for your voice command without draining the battery? By using a new tactic to separate different elements of the system on a cluster of processors. The feature that listens for your voice is powered on its own chip, so it doesn't burn through the battery. The Moto X is said to get one full day of battery life with normal use. So why would you go with a Moto X instead of the Droids at Verizon? A few reasons. Software-wise, the Moto X won't have any Verizon's extra junk preloaded on it, but it will be sold at Verizon as well as four other U.S. carriers, AT&T, T-Mobile, Sprint, and U.S. Cellular. Motorola phones have previously been disjointed on different carriers before, and having the same phone on every carrier will give the brand more strength to take on the Galaxy S and iPhone. And the Moto X brand will have more versions, including a cheaper one for no-contract customers. The Moto X is assembled in America, and it has a 4.7-inch screen with a curved back, and that backside will be customizable. If you order through the Moto Maker website, customers can pick from a variety of colors and accents, and you'll be able to eventually order it in different types of wood. Yes, wood, with options like bamboo, teak, ebony, and rosewood. Customization will only be available at first for AT&T. The other carriers will follow. If you buy it from a store, the only options will be black and white with 16 gigs of memory for $200 under contract. And these phones will be rolling out at the end of this month. Motorola is working with Seoul Republic to make headsets, Bluetooth speakers, and cases that match the Moto X's custom colors. That's your Tech News Update. You can dive into more details at CNET.com/update. From our studios in New York, I'm Bridget Carey.